आई एम जेबीएम डॉक्टर सुरेंद्र कुमार श्रीवास्तव फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस अंडर द फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथोडोलॉजी ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस सम थ्योरम्स ऑन द एनालिटिक कन्फॉर्मल ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन. लेट एफ जेड बी द एनालिटिक फंक्शन ऑफ जेड इन डोमेन डी ऑफ द जेड प्लेन एंड लेट एफ डैश जेड इज नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो इन डोमेन डी. Then the mapping W is equal to FZ is conformal at all points of D. For proving, let W is equal to FZ be an analytic function of Z in domain D of the Z plane, and Z not be an interior point of D. Further, suppose that C1 and C2 be two continuous curves passing through Z naught of Z. Suppose these curves have tangent at Z naught, making angles alpha 1 and alpha 2 respectively with the real axis. Let Z1 and Z2 be the points on the curves C1 and C2 respectively at the same distance R from the point Z naught, where R is small. Thus we can write Z1 minus Z0 is equal to R e to the power I theta 1 and Z2 minus Z0 is equal to R e to the power I theta 2. If R tends to 0, then the line Z1 Z0 and Z2 Z0 tends a tangent, that is theta tends to alpha 1 and theta 2 tends to alpha 2 as R tends to 0. Let W0, W1 and W2 be the images in W plane of the points Z0, Z1, Z2 respectively in Z plane. Suppose the tangent at W0 to the curves gamma 1 and gamma 2 make angles beta 1 and beta 2 with the real axis. Also let W1 minus W0 is equal to rho 1 e to the power I phi 1 and W2 minus W0 is equal to rho 2 e to the power I phi 2, where phi 1 tends to beta 1 as rho 1 tends to 0 and phi 2 tends to beta 2 as rho 2 tends to 0. Since FZ is analytic, then F dash Z is equal to limit Z1 tends to Z0 FZ1 minus FZ0 upon Z1 minus Z0. Limit Z1 tends to Z0 W1 minus W0 upon Z1 minus Z0. Limit Z1 tends to Z0 rho 1 e to the power I phi 1 upon R e to the power I theta 1. Limit Z1 tends to Z0 rho 1 upon R e to the power I phi 1 minus theta 1. Let F dash Z0 is equal to R0 e to the power I theta 0. It follows that limit Z1 tends to Z0 rho 1 e to the power I phi 1 minus theta 1 upon R is equal to capital R naught e to the power I theta 0. Since capital R naught is equal to limit Z1 tends to Z0 rho 1 upon R and limit phi 1 minus theta 1 is equal to theta 0. Limit phi 1 is equal to limit theta 1 plus theta or beta 1 is equal to alpha 1 plus theta 0. Thus the curve gamma 1 has a definite tangent at omega W naught, making angle alpha 1 plus theta 0 with the real axis. Similarly, we can show that gamma 2 has a definite tangent at omega 0, making angle alpha 2 plus theta 0 with real axis, that is beta 2 is equal to alpha 2 plus theta 0. Then the angle between the tangent at omega 0 to the curves gamma 1 and gamma 2 is equal to beta 2 minus beta 1 is equal to alpha 2 plus theta 0 minus alpha 1 minus alpha 0 is equal to alpha 2 minus alpha 1, which is the same as the angle between the C2 and C1. Therefore, the transformation W is equal to FZ is conformal. Now we see the problem. Find the images of the circle mod of Z minus 2 is equal to 2 under the Mobius transformation W is equal to Z upon Z plus 1. W is equal to Z upon Z plus 1, that implies WZ plus W is equal to Z. So Z is equal to W upon 1 minus W. Now, mod of z minus 2 is equal to 2. That implies mod of z minus 2 to the whole of square is equal to 2 square. So, this can be written as z minus 2, z bar minus 2 is equal to 4. So, z minus 2 is equal to w upon 1 minus w minus 2 is equal to 3w minus 2 upon 1 minus w. And z bar minus 2 is equal to 3w bar minus 2 upon 1 minus w bar. Now from second we can write 3w minus 2 upon 1 minus w and 3w bar minus 2 upon 1 minus w bar is equal to 4. After solving this equation we can write u square plus v square minus 4 by 5 u is equal to 0. Center of the circle is equal to minus g comma minus f is equal to 2 upon 5 comma 0 and the radius is equal to root g square plus f square minus c is equal to 2 by 5. Image as a circle with center 2 by 5 and radius is equal to 2 by 5 in the w plane. Now we see the next theorem. If the mapping w is equal to fz is conformal, then show that fz is analytic function of z. Let w is equal to fz is equal to u plus iv. Also let u is equal to u of xy, v is equal to v of xy are equations which define the conformal transformation from z plane to w plane. Let ds and d sigma are the line element in z and w plane respectively. Then ds square is equal to dx square plus dy square and d sigma square is equal to du square plus dv square. We know du is equal to dever u over dever x dx plus dever u over dever y dy and dv is equal to dever v over dever x dx plus dever v over dever y dy. Squaring and adding, then this can be written as du square plus dv square is equal to dever u over dever x to the whole of square dx square plus dever u over dever y to the whole of square dy square plus 2 dever u over dever x dever u over dever y dx dy plus dever v over dever x to the whole of square dx to the square dever v over dever y to the whole of square dy square 2 dever v over dever x dever v over dever y dx dy. Again this can be written as dever u over dever x to the whole of square plus dever v over dever x to the whole of square dx square plus in second bracket dever u over dever y to the whole of square plus dever v over dever y to the whole of square dy square plus 2 times dever u over dever x dever u over dever y plus dever v over dever x dever v over dever y dx dy is equal to d sigma square. This is dx square plus dy square ds square. So we can write dever u over dever x to the whole of square plus dever v over dever x to the whole of square is upon 1 is equal to dever u over dever x to the whole of square dever v over dever y to the whole of square upon 1 is equal to dever u over dever x dever u over dever y plus dever v over dever x dever v over dever y whole upon 0. So we can write dever u over dever x to the whole of square plus dever v over dever y to the whole of square is equal to dever u over dever y to the whole of square plus dever v over dever y to the whole of square and dever u over dever x dever u over dever y plus dever v over dever x dever v over dever y is equal to 0. That is dever u over dever x into dever u over dever y is equal to minus dever v over dever x dever v over dever y. So we can write this dever u over dever x is equal to alpha dever v over dever y and dever v over dever x is equal to minus lambda dever u over dever y. By equation third, lambda square dever v over dever y to the whole of square plus lambda square dever u over dever y to the whole of square is equal to dever u over dever y to the whole of square plus dever v over dever y to the whole of square. Or this can be written as lambda square minus 1 dever u over dever y to the whole of square minus dever v over dever y to the whole of square is equal to 0. That is alpha square minus 1 is equal to 0. That is alpha is equal to plus minus 1. Now taking alpha is equal to 1, then by equation k we can write डेवर यू ओवर डेवर एक्स, डेवर यू ओवर डेवर एक्स इज इक्वल टू डेवर वी ओवर डेवर वाई एंड डेवर यू ओवर डेवर वाई इज इक्वल टू माइनस डेवर वी ओवर डेवर एक्स. द एबव इक्वेशन आर कॉसी रीमान इक्वेशन एंड हैंस डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू एफ जेड इज ए कॉसी इज ए एनालिटिक फंक्शन. थैंक यू.